process again, just extrude out the surface of the glass and extrude the weight off the throw pipe. You just can't be afraid of each other. He's going to place the glass down into a foot crimp, and this is what's going to give it a fluted edge. He's now picked up a tool called a jack, which looks like a large pair of tweezers. And he would have...
We might need to scoot in just a little bit.
Again, he's going to flare out the edges and place it down into the foot crimp, and this is what's going to give it the tighter edge, tighter crimp edge, I should say. And he's now placing the three-point crimp in freehand. This will also begin with a gather. The gather on this shop is a gentleman right here in the red shirt. And he'll be gathering the glass with a pucky. A pucky is just a long steel rod that has a ceramic ball on the end. Now after he has gathered the glass, he's going to take the glass over to the mold with the presser. The gentleman in the yellow shirt will then snip the glass with a pair of shears. The presser is going to determine how much glass goes into the mold. If we put too much in, the mold is going to overflow. If we don't put enough in, it's just not going to look like a three right now.
I'm going to guess that it's a candlestick, but I could be wrong. It might be a voter. It might be a fountain lamp. Not quite. They'll have a reaction with the heat and cause the top of it to turn a red color.
More questions?